may be a little cheesy, but I needed to do it in honor of the man himself, the game, Triple H there. Yeah, hi. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. Breaking news in the apparently. And this does suck. You know, first now we losing The Undertaker. You know, now he's retiring. Now another end of an era. Indeed, an end of an era in pro wrestling. So Triple H, on an ESPN interview, has announced that he is retiring from in-ring competition. Doesn't mean we're never going to see him in WWE again. Most likely we're not going to, we are going to still see him somewhat sometime. But it's not like he's going to wrestle anymore, unfortunately. Which is a darn shame. It's definitely part of your childhood kind of died. I did not expect this, obviously. You would expect maybe Triple H, you know, he'll at least have one more match to, like, you know, have a better send-off. But sadly, no. This is from ESPN, so it's being reported. On ESPN's First Take, Triple H announces that he's never going to wrestle again as he has a defibrillator in his chest and can't take any more damage. So this is following his heart attack. I know I didn't do a video about his heart attack, but like thankfully he's fine. I think I mentioned in the video though, but man, it sucks. Like, fuck. Like, this is a man who would give anything for this business, okay? I may not like Triple H in terms of him booking, because I'm not a fan of him trying to cater to the smarks. You know, him catering to the smarky wrestling fans. You know, with that NXT stuff. I know smarks like it, you know, they like the NXT, whatever, but whatever, but Triple H, like it or not, Triple H, one of the best wrestlers to ever come from the business. Like or not, one of the best you know, it's sad, like, really, right after also Scott Hall passing away. This is what we're learning, too, like, this is what's going on. That Triple H, he's retiring, you know? Way to freaking hurt, like, you know, yeah, definitely, you know, it sucks. At least, like, the guy, you know, he's not gonna die or whatever, you know, he's taking care of his health and shit like that, but, like, it sucked, like, unfortunately, doesn't, like, cause, like, what, his last match was in Saudi Arabia against Randy Orton, and I'll be honest with you, that match wasn't even really that great, like, that's the sad part, the match wasn't really that good, it was, like, a disappointing match. I thought the match would be good. And if it had, like, a better story. Like, sure, the backstory of Orton and Triple H. But, like, I remember what I wanted, like, what the match should have been. The match could have been, like, better if remember when they did the whole Ric Flair, like, getting attacked by Batista thing, where it led to Triple H and Batista? You could have easily made that, Orton got involved, like, leading to Batista attacking Ric Flair, you know? That could have also advanced, like, a story and shit like that. But plus, also, the match was kind of, like, disappointing. The match was kind of slow. That was, like, my opinion. I'm not saying it's the worst match, but, like, the match could have been way better. They had way better matches. Is it, like, the thing is, like, the match felt like, yeah, what happened at WrestleMania 25, in all honesty. You know? That's just the reality. Like, maybe if the match was no DQ, the match would have been better. I don't know. So, the last thing we will see Triple H also, like, kind of getting physical was back in January 2021 when he and Orton had their random fight. Like, they decided to fight for some reason. So that's basically sort of like Triple H's last competitive fight. It wasn't even a match. It was just a fight, you know? And that's sadly the last time, and he didn't even do a pedigree, unfortunately. So we're never going to see a pedigree again, I guess. That sucks. Like, fuck. Like, Triple H, you know? He will never, unfortunately, have, like, a good retirement. Like, he will never have, like, what Undertaker was hoping for or all these wrestlers would hope for, like, a good send-off. Like, Triple H, one of the best wrestlers of all time, like it or not. Like, first of all, freaking great character. Like, aside from him marrying Stephanie McMahon, like, Okay, well, guess what? Like, for people saying, like, oh, he got pushed because of marrying Stephanie. But here's the thing. They were already pushing him way before having him with Stephanie. You know? And if anything, like, who cares? Like, it's a beautiful love story, okay? It's an amazing love story. Him and freaking Stephanie getting together. A beautiful story. Love story, okay? It's like, maybe, you know, WWE is a beautiful place to be a matchmaker. You know, it's the love guru. You know what I mean? But like, yeah, he was already getting pushed. He had great character. He cared for this business, you know. He actually looked like a wrestler, act like a wrestler. He could cut great promos. The guy is actually a great, he's like the master on the mic. The guy knows how to fucking cut good promos. And he is a legit good wrestler, you know. He knows that, he actually knows in-ring psychology. He actually knows what to freaking do, what works in the ring. Okay, some people say he's boring. I don't know what the fuck y'all talking about. How is he boring? Like, what's so boring about him? Like, he's, what, is it because, like, he looked at, like a wrestler? Is it because you guys hate him for, like, freaking, you know, marrying Stephanie? Like, don't be wrong. Hey, like, you know, Stephanie McMilf, holy hell. But, like, God bless them. Like, I'm happy for them, man. I'm happy for it, but I'm happy for them. They're fucking great couple, you know what I mean? They love each other, you know, it's cool. Who gives a shit, you know? Let them be. Did Triple H use, like, you know, him marrying into the business, did that help him? Sure. But like it or not, like, at least he knew, like, he can entertain people, like, at least, like, imagine if, let's say, imagine Test, like, rest in peace, imagine if Test was to marry Stephanie in real life. Do you really think that Test would be just as entertaining as Triple H? I don't think so, okay? I'm sorry, that would not be. Like, Triple H, he actually freaking entertained people. Going back to his D-Generation X days with Shawn Michaels, you know? Them and D-Generation X along with the New Age Outlaws and X-Pac, okay? Way before, you know, yeah, okay, sure, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, but that wasn't really as cool what happened when he was in D-Generation X. Then freaking becoming his own wrestler, coming into his own, becoming Triple H, legit Triple H, you know, the Cerebral Assassin, the Game, and all that stuff, you know, having great feuds with The Rock, Kurt Angle, Mick Foley, for fuck's sakes, you know, Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Undertaker, so many great matches from this man, and you guys gonna say that he's not that great of a wrestler? Come on, get the fuck out of here. So many great matches from this man. Amazing. Amazing wrestler. Great character this guy had. This guy freaking done it all for the business. And then, you know, again, I'm not a fan of his booking. The reason, like, I'm not saying he doesn't legit have a brain. Like, I'm not saying, like, his entire booking is terrible, but I'm sorry. Him trying to cater to Sparks is a problem. But apparently, he still has a mind for the business. Like, he knows, like, freaking, you know, what draws or not. But, like, he still wants to cater to the Sparks to make them shut up. But, like, because of caring them, that kind of helped ruin the business. So, that kind of, it doesn't help. But apparently, like, he likes Smarky shit, which, come on, bro. You gotta stop that. And, you know, I don't know. Him liking China, trying to make Stephanie man China, like, liking these manly bitches. I don't know. You do you, brother. You do you. You're a man's man. You do you. But freaking Triple H is amazing, yo. Like it or not, Triple H can actually entertain the business. He's one of the best of all time. Definitely a certified Hall of Famer. Maybe he'll be the Hall of Fame next year. But it's sad. Like, wow, this guy. I mean, he's already in the Hall of Fame with DX, but that sucks. Like, this guy, he's never gonna have a proper retirement. I understand, like, he's already was a part-timer anyways, but just, like, Man, that just goes to show, like, wow, he can't come back anymore. If WWE desperately needs ratings, he's not going to be there. Like, look what happened. The guy had a heart attack. He's not going to be, you can't use him. He can't be there to save you, people. He can't be there to save you. I mean, part of the reason, let's be honest here, as much as I love Triple H, since he apparently is part of the booking, part of it is his fault. And I understand, all these wrestlers, they're not stars. They don't look like wrestlers, they don't act like wrestlers. And when it comes time that when they need someone to fucking save the show, Triple H won't be one of them. Because he has to retire, and he can't take any more damage, or else he could legit affect his fucking health. What does that tell you? It's a darn shame, man. It's a darn fucking shame. And it makes me sad as a Triple H fan. Like, because I love Triple H. Well, Triple H is one of my... Probably even, like, my top 10. That's the sad part. I mean, lost Undertaker. My number one favorite. Like, he's retired. He's done. Which, good for him. Honestly, it's important. He should, you know? He doesn't need to prove himself anymore. He already had a great career. Triple H, good career. Great career, you know? Done it all. Obviously, like, the send-off, it's like... You know, obviously, like, you would hope he, like, everyone has this perfect send-off, right? I mean, at least, like, the last thing he did, you know, yeah, he did with a rival Randy Orton, you know, I guess it's fitting, you know, him facing Orton's last match, his last interaction of fighting was with Orton, sure, you know. It's just, I'm a bit disappointed, though, like, because the match at Saudi Arabia was, but yeah, that's the sad thing, the last match was in Saudi Arabia, like, I don't know. If anything, I would, fuck, like, it wouldn't even make more sense, honestly, have him retire against Batista. You know, honestly, like, fuck it, you know, so be it. Have that be the last match. Imagine if Triple H lost. Because, again, Batista, like, you know, an end of both eras. That would have been more emotional, too. But, I mean, we didn't know, right? We didn't know what would happen, but that would have been, so be it. That would have been a way better way to go, I guess. And after all, the match at WrestleMania was pretty good, too. So, again, like, for people to go, Triple H, oh, but he only needs weapons. Who gives a shit? The guy's a good wrestler. And even in a normal match, he actually had great normal matches, for God's sakes. What was a normal match? Like, freaking him versus The Rock in a non-stipulation match. It's so entertaining. A great match. They're fucking 60-minute Ironman matches. Like, one of the best Ironman matches I've seen. Probably, if anything, probably better than Bret Hart versus Shawn Michaels. I'll be honest with you. Okay, their ladder match, like, so many matches, it doesn't matter if it's a stipulation match or a non-stipulation match, the guy knows how to work. He has actually good inner psychology. He has a good move set. He knows how to move, knows how to do things in the ring. He's a good fucking wrestler. So for people who hate him claiming he's boring, go fuck yourself. If it wasn't for guys like him, there wouldn't be no any wrestler today. The guy actually fucking legit fucking almost died for this business. God bless him. I may not be a big fan of his NXT bookings because he tried to cater to the smarky wrestling fans, which is a problem. But God damn it, I love Triple H. Triple H, you rule. You will always rule. You're the fucking man. It's a darn shame that this guy has to retire. Because this guy, he's freaking... What can you say? Like, I feel definitely today part of your childhood kind of died. I could not believe it. Like... I understand, but, like, fuck, like, come on, I'm being honest here. Like, the fact that he legit has to retire now, wow, I don't know what to tell you. Definitely part of your childhood definitely died today, people. For those who were fans of Triple H, those who were entertained by him, this is definitely a now officially a sad day for wrestling fans that, and, like, wow, like, I go to see this and, like, a punch, or, like, right straight up fucking punch to the fucking heart. Like, wow, he's retiring. And it's understandable. It's understandable. And I understand he's old, but, like, it's understandable. It sucks. So, anyways, thank you, Triple H. Thank you for all you've done for the business. Thank you for all you've done. We love you. All the freaking people who haven't watched wrestling in a long time, or people who somewhat know wrestling, love you. And obviously, wrestling fans love you. Some people are going to now pretend to say he's the greatest of all time, even though fucking they were saying that this guy was boring. Or the age of Triple H, or the reign of terror. Shut up with the reign of terror. Who gives a fuck? The reign of, if anything, him being the first world champion on Raw, and freaking, he tried to help bring prestige to the world title. You know, him being the world champion and... That reign of terror you guys claim of actually helped brought prestige for that big gold. That's why you guys want to see the big gold back, right? It's because of guys like him and having that reign that he did. It helped the title, like it or not. Because look at the new title, the Universal title. Fucking, we had Finn Balor as the first champ. He got Boo Boo and had to lose it. Then Fat Ass Owens and Ratings Killers. Then it took until like Goldberg, Lesnar, and Roman Reigns to be the champion to actually help bring some prestige to the title, like it or not. Overall, Triple H is one of the best of all time. Definitely part of my top, probably even my top five, you know. Undertaker's number one still. Triple H, he's still the best, you know. I'm going to miss this guy wrestling. Obviously, he's not going to be gone forever in terms of television-wise, but it would be nice to see him on TV. It just sucks that he won't be competing, and like if especially when we need him. Like, especially he won't be able to have a perfect storybook ending, you know? But what can you do? I just hope nothing for the best for him and for his health, because what you can't really blame him, okay? Overall, that's what I'm going to say, people. Thank you, Triple H. We love you. God bless you. Thank you for the memories. Thank you for entertaining the world. That's all I have to say. Again, I just found this out, and it sucks. I'm, like, a bit sad with this, you know? I'm not going to, like, cry or whatever, but it's just, it's like, ah. But the thing is, you kind of, like, because, like, I honestly thought, even though he had the heart attack, he might come back for just at least one more match. But now it's like, oh, wow. It's that serious. It's a darn shame. But overall, thank you, Triple H. We love you. God bless you. Till next time. Peace. Yeah, bye.